Hi, I'm Bob Ward from Microsoft, from the SQL engineering team. I'm here today to show you a feature in SQL Server 2017 on Linux called automatic tuning. So you can see right here, I'm running a tool called Operation Studio connected to a SQL Server on Linux, and in this case, Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Now what I've done is I've taken the popular Wide World Importer sample database and I've made some modifications. One thing I've done is added a stored procedure that takes an integer parameter. And the reason I did this is because automatic tuning has this capability based on query store, if you enable query store, to detect query plan regression problems, performance problems, where a given query has a change in query plan and experiences a regression in performance from previous plans used in cache. So let me show you how this works. In this particular case, I've got a script called initialize. This stored procedure that I've built in the sample is simply going to initialize our demo environment. So I'll run that first. Now I've done something interesting here. Because we're running SQL Server on Linux, we don't have Windows Performance Monitor, which sometimes is used to show this demonstration. So thank you to my colleague in SQL Server, Pedro Lopes. He created a script for me that actually takes SQL Server Dynamic Management View performance counter information and puts this into a global temporary table in a loop. In this particular case, I'm monitoring batch requests per second, which is a popular counter to measure SQL Server throughput workload. So I'll run that script to start capturing data. This script over here called batch request.sql will actually query that global temporary table and show me what the current throughput is for queries run against the SQL Server on Linux. Now here's the interesting part. Because I'm using SQL Operation Studio, and because the results have been put into this format of counter, time, and value, we can take advantage of this new feature to take a result set and turn it into a chart. So I'll click here to time series, and now I've got a chart that shows what performance looks like. Now, right now the performance doesn't look a little skewed because I'm not actually running any queries. But that's the technique we're going to use to actually show what query performance looks like in this demo. This script right here is running this stored procedure I told you about in a loop, just 10,000 batches is just running. Let me just kick this off right here. And then we can go back to batchrequest.sql and observe what that performance is going to look across of time. This will be what we would consider our typical workload throughput for our application. So I'll click on time series and you'll see now that this part of the right hand of the graph is what the throughput normally looks like. Now let me bring up another script called regression.sql, and this is what it's going to do. It's going to, in the stored procedure, it's going to clear procedure cache, plan cache, to simulate a scenario where a stored procedure gets, a plan gets evicted from cache, say memory pressure occurs. Another user comes in, executes the same stored procedure, this time with a different parameter value, which causes a different plan to come into cache that may not be optimal for all users. In the SQL Server world, we call this scenario parameter sniffing. So I'm going to run this regression procedure now. I'm going to go back and I'm going to look at batch requests per second and see what the performance looks like. And if you go look at the chart again, you'll be able to observe here that performance is now degraded significantly. Imagine this scenario. You're contacted over the weekend on a severe performance problem for SQL, and this kind of a behavior occurs, and you're not sure what to do. But you've enabled query store in your database in SQL Server 2017, so you can go into a script like this and query a DMV that we've built to see what recommendations we have. And in this case, you can see here that we have detected inside the engine, built in, when query store is enabled, that a performance regression has occurred. Performance for average CPU time for this query has gone up significantly. And the reason we detected this is that there was a plan change occurred, but the regression in performance was observed. Now, if this occurs, you can actually run this script right here with this system stored procedure to revert back to the previous plan that you know had good performance. And then you would fix the problem. But you still were interrupted over the weekend, which is not optimal, but at least you were able to fix it very quickly. This is what I call the default behavior in SQL 17, or the recommendations behavior. You enable query store, we will detect these recommendations, you can then take action. Let me show you another option you might have though. Let me stop collecting the workload, let me stop running the report, and I'm going to bring in another script here that's going to allow me to turn on something called automatic tuning. So I've got query store still enabled. The auto-tune procedure will do an alter database option to turn on the automatic tuning feature in SQL Server. Let me run that script now. I'll connect to my SQL Server to run it. And this will now turn on automatic tuning. Now let me go back now and recollect the data I started to collect in the first scenario. So I'm going to kick this off and make sure that data is being collected properly. in my system. I'm then going to kick off the report workload again, which again is going to run this stored procedure with the normal parameter. And I'm going to observe my batch request per second. And you can see here just by looking at these numbers, and we'll see it here by looking at a chart, what performance looks like for my normal workload. Scroll down, look at time series. So there's my normal workload performance. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce this regression again. But this time, instead of having to me go and look at the recommendations and fix the problem, SQL Server is going to automatically revert back to the last known good plan that had good performance. So I'll click in the regression to make sure it runs. I'll go back and look at my chart. And just by looking at these values on the screen, you're going to see that they go down, but then you're going to see they go right back up. So I'll click that. I'll look at time series. I'll go back. And now you can see what's occurred. Here was your workload performance. Performance went down because of the regression problem, but then SQL Server automatically corrected it and performance went back up. It's slightly faster in this case because we're forcing a plan. That doesn't occur in every situation, but it's an observation of SQL automatically tuning your database and fixing a query plan regression problem. If you go back, look at the recommendations DMV now and run this query, you get similar information where we detected the regression problem, but this time you'll notice something called state transition says last good plan forced. This is an indication that SQL Server has automatically corrected the problem and tuned it for you. And in this case, you did not get called over the weekend. In fact, you just got an email maybe on Monday when you came into the office that there was some blip in the matrix and things actually corrected themselves automatically. So that's a feature called automatic tuning. It's available on SQL Server 2017 on Linux, SQL 17 on Windows, and in Azure SQL Database. One quick comment about this functionality is that we monitor the changes we've made automatically, and we can revert back if we've noticed they've actually caused any further performance problems. So again, automatic tuning, turn on query store in SQL 17 on Linux, get recommendations by default, turn on automatic tuning, and watch SQL Server automatically correct query plan regression performance problems. I hope you've enjoyed this demonstration. You can get this demo yourself and run it if you'll just go in your favorite search engine and look for my repo. Look on GitHub, Bob SQL, and my repo. There's an automatic tuning demo that you can run here, both for SQL Server on Linux and SQL Server on Windows. Thank you for your time today.